name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate what happens when we add salt to a soaked polymer. For the experiment, I am going to bring in my previously soaked polymers. This one is with deionized water. And this one is with tap water. And finally, I am going to need some salt to add to it. I'm going to start with my polymer that was soaked in deionized water, and I'm going to add very small amounts of salt, essentially almost grain-wise. And you should already start seeing the top layer clearing up. And it definitely looks a lot more like water. And as we swirl around a little bit, the polymer should slowly release the water. And notice how when I add the salt, it's no longer impeded by the gel layer that was originally there, which means that we extracted almost all the water from the polymer. So what can you do now? This is the part where you have to be careful with the disposal. The solution from the top can be poured down the drain, but the soaked gel that is still on the bottom should be disposed of in the trash. Otherwise, it will clog up the drain. Now let's do the same thing with the tap water to see how it works. This is our polymer that was soaked in tap water. We add some salt to it, and notice where the salt grains are falling. Just like before, we start seeing our polymer release some of the water. Let's add some more salt and just a little bit more. And as the salt falls through the solution, we notice that there is very little gel on the bottom now. And it is mostly water. The disposal is the same like with the other example. We're going to discard the water down the drain, and we're going to discard the soaked polymer residue in the trash.